students. I hope all of you are well by the grace of Almighty Allah. I am also well by His grace. Students, in our previous sessions of science class, we have discussed so many topics of chapter 11, which was related to light. Today we are going to discuss about a specific organ which is directly related with light. Actually, without that organ, we are not able to feel the existence of light. What is that organ? Can you tell me what is the organ of our body? Yes, you will tell me that, ma'am, our eyes makes us feel to the existence of light. So without our eyes, we cannot see the light. That's why we are going to discuss today the internal structure of a human eye. So let's move on to our today's topic. Students, look at the whiteboard. I think all of you are seeing this picture very, very clearly. There is a picture drawn on the whiteboard. Actually, I have drawn it for all of you. It will help us to make us known about the different parts of our eyes. This is the figure of a dissected eyeball. Actually, our eye contains a section. It is a hole type which is carrying a white color ball, and this is eyeball. If you dissect the eyeballs like this, if this is the ball, if you dissect like this, this is the eyeball, and if you dissect like this, you will find this figure. If you dissect the eyeball like this, and after dissection, if I show the dissected part to all of you like this, you will see this view. I think all of you are clear right now. So let's see. This is the figure of an dissected eyeball. In our eyeball, these parts are present, and we are going to discuss each and every part of our eyeball. This is the whole figure. The outermost covering of the eyeball is sclera. This one is sclera. Under the sclera, there is another layer which is choroid. It is blackish in color. It helps us to prevent the unnecessary reflection inside our eyes. Actually, so many light rays enters into our eyes, but all the light rays are not necessary to make an image. So the unnecessary light rays are absorbed by this choroid. Next, this one. Actually, see this one. This leaf type things. What is this? This is a lens. This is a biconvex lens. Biconvex means such type of things, and concave means such type of things. The lens which are such type of figure, that means both sides are bulged like this, is called biconvex lens, and such type of lens are called concave lens. Actually, our eye's lens is biconvex lens. So this is a biconvex lens, and this lens is attached with this muscle, and this muscle type portion is known as iris. Actually, students, sometimes you see that the color of our eyeballs are not same in all the countries. The foreigners' eyes are in bluish color. Someone's eye have brownie eyes, the color of this portion is brown type, and this portion is black in color. But what is the natural color of this one? The natural color of human eye is blue. As we are a mixed nation, that's why our eyes color is black, but the natural color is blue. By the way, why is the color of human eye differs? The color differs due to this iris, this muscle type things. The iris color changes. That's why the eyeball, actually this is the color of iris, not the color of eyeball. The change of iris color, our eyes color differ from person to person. Next we have discussed four portion. First one was sclera, the outer thinner layer of eyeball, and under this that was another layer which was choroid. It prevents the unnecessary light reflection inside our eyes, and this one is biconvex lens, and the lens is attached with these two types of muscles, and these muscles are known as iris. Students, if you see very sincerely, you will find that here this one is the portion of iris, and this one is portion also, and this portion is making a hole. This portion is empty. Actually, this is a hole. This hole is known as pupil. Actually, if you see your eyes closely in a mirror, you will find that there is a small hole in your eye, and this is known as pupil. So it is the pupil. This portion is created by this portion. This portion is known as pupil. And if you see very sincerely, that you will find that the eyeball has a bulged portion like this. This bulged portion is known as cornea. This one is cornea. And the last one is this. There are so many nerves. These nerves helps to feel the feelings of seeing anything. Think you are seeing a fish, and this feelings is transmitted to your brain through this optic nerve. These are the optic nerve. There are another two things which are not described still now. There are vitreous humor, and another is aqueous humor. What is aqueous humor and what is vitreous humor? There are some jelly-like substances which are inside the eyeball. Actually, I have not identified one thing, and that one is retina. This one. Retina. What is retina? In the inner part of the eyeball, there is a pink colored layer inside the eyeball. Actually, under the choroid, this pink colored layer is known as retina. Any kind of image is formed on the wall of this retina. Actually, the image of anything is made on retina is not in the right position. It is totally in the opposite position of anything. Like this one is the marker, and the image will be like in the opposite position, and thus the image will be formed on this, the wall of retina. This opposite position of an image is changed to our brain. When such type of information is transmitted to our brain through optic nerve, it is changed or it is corrected by our brain. Let's move on to our remaining topic, which was vitreous humor. What is vitreous humor? Actually, vitreous humor is a jelly-like substance which is situated between retina and cornea. That means, sorry, retina and lens. I'm really sorry, retina and lens. Which is, you can say cornea too, it is not wrong. Actually, the jelly-like substance which is situated between the lens or lens and retina, it is called vitreous humor. And what is aqueous humor? Aqueous humor is situated in this position, and this position is situated between cornea and lens. In this plank position, there are some watery substance which is known as aqueous humor. When we cry, this aqueous humor comes down like as tears. So these were the discussion, this was the discussion on the internal structure of a human eye. I am summarizing all the topic again. Sclera, the outermost covering of an eyeball. And under the sclera there is choroid, which prevents the it is a blackish in color. It prevents the unnecessary reflection inside our eye. And under the choroid there is retina. Retina is a pink color layer. The retina helps to form an image on the wall of retina. The image is formed in the opposite direction. And when the feelings of this image is sent to our brain, our brain then makes it corrected in the real position. Then I'm going for the next portion. This one is the muscle type organ which is holding the lens like this. This muscle type organ is iris. Iris differs in man to man in color. Due to the color variation of iris, the eyes of our human beings differs from person to person, actually country to country sometimes. And this lens is a biconvex lens. And this lens is holding by this ciliary muscle, and iris also makes iris is making a hole inside this, and this hole type of portion is known as pupil. And in the eyeball of a human being there is a bulged portion, and this bulged portion is known as cornea. Cornea is transparent. So that was all about our I'm missing another thing, which is aqueous humor and vitreous humor. Vitreous humor is a jelly-like substance which is situated between lens and retina, and aqueous humor is a watery substance which is situated between cornea and lens. When we cry, this aqueous humor comes as tear. So this was the discussion on internal structure of a human eye. I think if you read the whole book very very sincerely, you will make a vast and clear idea about the internal structure of a human eye. So thanks to all of you, and I'm requesting you to complete the worksheet very very sincerely. Allah Hafiz for today.